things you've already gathered, that was a problem. So, I wish I could say I just was such a good Christian and I just had all these whole journal thoughts. No, I was just ill and frustrated and not able to talk, and I had a little dry erase board that dyslexic left-handed dad had to write on. When you're left-handed, you're wiping it off while you're writing. And I was just ill most of the time. And at night, I would come home, and I would just, it was tough. And I would go down in my basement, my old studio room, and I started drawing again. That was all I really knew how to do as a kid. And when I started writing and doing songs, I didn't really do artwork anymore. And suddenly, I had just finished a record called Only Jesus, and I couldn't sing it. And I just had to sit there. And I would just sit in rooms, and it's really awkward when you're the one not talking and everybody knows. They just start looking at you going, you know? And I would go to church, and I would just have to sit there during worship and not sing. It was awful. And not knowing how it was going to end. So I would go down in my little room, and I would draw. And God had to remind me of some things in that little room. God had to remind me that I'm not a singer. I'm a child of God who sings. And singing can come and go. But who I am isn't based on what I can do. If I base who I am on that, I'm in trouble. And I had to be stripped down to just knowing that at base level, I'm His. And every day I get up, it's worthy of my worship. And I've got to point to Him some way. And Megan's going to sing the song. It's a special song, one of the first songs I ever wrote. And it was one that God kept taking me back to remind me. I am who He says I am. I am who He has made me. And this is how I worship in the quiet place.
Who am I if the Lord? Lift our voices and sing together.